A portion of this video is sponsored by Upbeat.
HiShoot is a screenshot framing app that makes your boring screenshot look awesome. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can make your own templates for HiShoot. I will also be sharing some of my own free templates at the end of the video.
But first, let me talk to you about today's sponsor, Upbeat. Audio is an essential part of a YouTube video. There is a reason why tutorials are objectively hated when you hear dubstep in it as the narrator is talking.
This is how you download video files.
As any content creator would tell you, finding the right music for the right mood can be very hard, especially if you're looking for royalty-free music that won't land you in jail. Which is why I'm very happy to tell you about Upbeat, a library of thousands of copyright-free music for your YouTube videos that won't land you in jail. Upbeat allows you to sort music by energy, vocals, and duration. Their curated playlists are super handy for quickly jumping into specific moods. You can also search for moods and other playlists. Using music from Upbeat is as simple as copy and paste. If you like a song, just click on download and copy the credits. Then paste those credits into your video's description when you upload. Upbeat whitelists your video as long as you have the song's credits along with its generated license key in the description of your video, which in my opinion is a great deal. All music and sound effects you hear in this video are from Upbeat. The free account allows you to download 10 tracks per month, but if you purchase a monthly or lifetime premium subscription, which I mean is unreal that they even offer a lifetime subscription, you can download unlimited tracks and you don't have to worry about giving credits in your description. Premium account also gives you access to their massive sound effect library as well.
The sound effect library is also conveniently organized by moments such as awkward, celebrate, creator, voice clips, etc.
They even have meme sounds in here. Listen to these.
Christmas is cancelled.
Be sure to check out Upbeat from the link in the description or in the pinned comment. I'm sure you'll love it. Big thanks to Upbeat for sponsoring this video. Now back to HiShooting.
There are a few important things you need to have before proceeding. First, you need a PC. Doesn't matter what OS the PC is running, if you can run a browser on it, it will be just fine. Technically, you can also use your phone, but I wouldn't go through that headache. It's just way too complicated. Second is obviously your phone, with HiShoot 2i installed. I will be using the material fork of HiShoot made by Pasha Puma, which has a better template manager and a more pleasant user interface. Links to both will be in the description. We will also be installing some additional apps, but we will do that later in the video. All good? Let's get into it. The first step is to find a good frame to use for your screenshot. You can use an image from Unsplash, or you can take an image yourself, or you can use a graphic you design yourself. Please don't take a graphic from the internet because you may be infringing someone's copyrights and nobody wants that. Whatever you end up using, make sure that your screenshot area is fully visible in the frame. And please, for the love of God, don't use an iPhone for your screenshot. It's like putting mayonnaise on a pizza. It makes no sense, alright? Please don't do it. For this video, I'll be using this Galaxy S10 frame I found on Unsplash. I will have it linked in the description if you want to practice on this along with me. I will be referring to this image as the background frame from now on in this tutorial. Now that we have a frame, open up your browser on your PC and go to photop.com. Click open from computer and select your background frame. To understand what we're going to do first, you need to understand how HiShoot places your screenshot over a background frame. Essentially, you give HiShoot X and Y coordinates of each corner of the display that is located in your background frame. Then, when you give your screenshot to HiShoot, it assigns these coordinates to all corners of your screen and place it in the right location based on the X and Y coordinates. To find these coordinates, open the info panel in Photop. You will notice X and Y coordinates change when you move your mouse around in your canvas. Zoom in on any corner of the phone's display. If your phone frame has rounded corners like mine here, select the pen tool, disable fill up at the top, and enable stroke. Give it any color you like. Click anywhere over the edge of the screen. Then click outside the screen to follow the top edge. Then click anywhere over the left edge. To adjust the line, hold Ctrl and click on the anchor to move it. And just like that, follow the entire screen to find all corner edges. Edges. Why does the word edges sound so like edges? No matter how normal I sounded, it just always sounds so deep, like edges. What? Why is this? Okay. Once you've done that, hover your mouse over each corner edge one by one and note down the X and Y coordinates. I like to note them down on my phone, but you can write them on a toilet paper or whatever you want, or you can even write it on your forehead. Who cares? Once you've noted down all the coordinates, you can delete the shape. Just select it and hit the delete button. Go to Image, Image Size, and note down the width and height of the image. The higher your background image resolution is, the better quality your final output in HiShoot will be, though 1080p is the recommended size. If you decide to change the resolution, make sure to note down the X and Y coordinates again, as they will change with your resolution.
HiShoot uses 4 layers of images to make your final output. These layers are as follows. At the top, you have your background frame with the display bit removed for your screenshot. Then on top is your screenshot which you select within HiShoot. Over that, we have an optional glare layer that is not true to its name. This layer is for any foreground objects that are visible over the display, such as rounded corners, a hand, camera cutout, or the glare itself. If your frame has both glare and rounded corners, you will put both on this layer. Over glare is an optional shadow layer with transparency. We will not be making a shadow layer in this tutorial, but essentially you just make selection of the shadow from the background frame and put it on a new layer. And that's basically it.
Double click on the background layer name and rename it to preview.jpg. This will be used as our preview image within HiShoot. Renaming the layers will help us keep everything organized. Press Ctrl+J to duplicate this layer. Rename it to frame.png. Using your favorite selection tool, make a selection of the phone's display. Magnetic lasso tool is the easiest one to use if you're a beginner.
There are a ton of tutorials on how to make selections on YouTube, so I will not be explaining how to do that in this video. Any Photoshop tutorial you can find will apply to Photopea.
Make sure you only select the display, leaving anything over the screen, such as camera cutout, a notch, or maybe someone's hand, or whatever it may be. Once you've selected it, click the layer mask icon to mask it out of the screen. Hide the preview layer to see it better. Press Ctrl+I to invert your mask. Alright, now that's our first layer complete. Pat yourself in the back and get hydrated. Next up is glare.
Like I said before, glare is not true to its name. This layer contains foreground elements that are over your screen. In this case, we don't have a glare, but we do have rounded corners, which is what we will isolate. To do that, we're just going to duplicate the background frame.
Alright, now you just have to hide everything, make each layer visible, and export it by going to File, Export, PNG. Set quality to 100 and save all of them like this except the preview image, which you will have to export as JPG rather than PNG. The app icon is completely optional, but if you want to personalize your template app by giving it a custom app icon, make an icon in 144 by 144 canvas and save it as a IC underscore launcher in PNG format. Again, this is a completely optional step. If you want to leave it and don't want an icon, just completely skip it. It will not make any difference. Alright, let's now move all these images where they belong. Download the template project from the description of this video. After downloading, extract the zip's content to a folder with 7-zip or WinRAR. Links to both will be in the description in case you're one of that 1% who doesn't have 7-zip for whatever reason. Navigate to SRC, Main, Res, Drawable, and drag and drop all your frame images into this folder. Click Replace when asked. If you didn't make the glare or shadow layers, just delete those from this archive, otherwise it will be visible and it will just overlap the default ones. If you made the icon for the template, go back and paste it into the MIPMAP XXX DPI folder. Next up, navigate to values folder within the res and open strings.xml with notepad. Change template v2 sample to whatever you want to call your template app. You can call it Samsung Galaxy S75 Ultra Pro 3D HiShoot 2i Template 2000 version 6 Alpha 9. Or you can call it whatever you want, just giving you an example on top of my head. Save it by pressing Ctrl+S after changing. Next, navigate to Assets folder within the main and open template.cfg. Again, with Notepad. Change whatever template name you chose earlier. This one will be visible within HiShoot. Change the author name to your name and, oh, would you look at that, the X and Y coordinates. How convenient. Type the ones you had noted down earlier in the correct places. Type in the background frame size we noted as well at the bottom in template width and height. Save it when you're done. Next step is to move this project folder into your phone. Use any method you like. Once the folder is in your phone, let's move on to the final steps, after this epic transition. Open a Google Play Store and install AIDE. Then search up APK Extractor and install that as well. Open IDE and tap for experts because we know what we're doing. Allow file access when you're asked. If you get the pop-up for subscription, tap continue free. You do not need to make any purchases to do any of this. Go back once and navigate to template project folder we moved to our phone earlier. Open app folder and then tap open this Android app project.
Hey Vsauce, Grabster here. I missed an important step. But what? You see, in the template folder, tap the build.grill to open it. Change the application ID to your own package name. Keep it simple and easy to remember, such as com.grabsterstudios.hishoottemplate or whatever you want to call it. This package name must be unique to every new template you make. If you're updating a template, make sure that the package name matches so that it can overwrite instead of creating a new instance. That's it. Vsauce out.
Then tap the play button at the top and it should start to build your APK. If you're asked to allow installing APKs from unknown source, make sure to allow it, then come back and install the APK. And now you have your template installed on your phone. Open HiShoot to test it out and make sure all the X and Y coordinates and layers are working as expected. If not, make the necessary changes and repeat the process. To share the APK with others, open the APK extractor, search your template app and tap it to extract it. And as promised at the beginning of the video, here are some templates I've made that you can download for free from grabsterstudios.netlify.com/HiShoot templates. I will be making more templates in the future, so be sure to follow me on Twitter if you want to see those when they come out. Here are some other videos you might be interested in that are also theming related. And that's it. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you in the next video. Peace out. Oh!